I'm going to talk to you today about open captions and why you should think about burning them into the video layer. Let's go to MovieCaptioner here, and I'm going to export as embedded QuickTime captions. Let's going to go ahead and put it into the movie here, and you see I have a translucent background. And so I could see the movie through it a little bit. Let's go to the QuickTime Pro Show Movie Properties window. And you could see that I have a video track, a soundtrack, and a text track. The text track is where the captions live. So if I uncheck it there, you could see they disappear. Now what happens if you were to upload this movie to, say, YouTube? It would not accept this text track. And you'd upload your movie and all of a sudden your captions are gone. You'd wonder where they went. Well, that's the problem. YouTube and, say, Windows Media Player and some other players don't support the QuickTime text track. So what you would have to do is burn this text track into the video track so it can't be ignored. So what you'd have to do is, if you have QuickTime Pro, it's easy. You can go to the file menu and say export. And while the captions are still in there, I could go to movie, to QuickTime Movie, and export it. After it's done exporting, you'll see that there's just a soundtrack and a video track now. The text track is now part of the video track. So if I scrolled through there again, I'll see the captions are still there and that translucent background, but there's no extra text track now. If you uploaded this to YouTube, it would work. The problem is that Apple, in their infinite wisdom, has stopped selling QuickTime Pro for QuickTime 7. So we need another solution. And the solution we're going to use is called iSkySoft Video Converter. And for this, we're going to need an SRT file. So in MovieCaptioner, I'm going to export as subrip SRT. And I'm going to save that to my desktop. Had one there already. And I'm going to quit out of MovieCaptioner. And I'll Now in iSkySoft's video converter, what we're going to do is drag our movie onto the interface, and then we need to add our SRT file that we just exported from MovieCaptioner. So I'm going to go under the edit menu, or you could go here, see I have it already selected, but I'm going to go here and select subtitle. And that's going to open up a little video.
Today I'm demonstrating the
I don't want the audio to play. And it is on the subtitle tab right now. And what you would do is click the subtitle pull-down window and say load subtitle. Find it on your computer. It's on my desktop here. And load it. And you probably don't have to mess with the encoding. Usually Unicode UTF-8 is fine. And you can reposition the captions up and down on the screen using the slider, but I'm going to leave them at the bottom. Now I'm going to click the font. It's set to Arial here. And I'm going to select Arial Bold. And I'm also going to click on the color tab up here, and it will open the little color window, and I'm going to make sure that's set to white. You can set it to any color you want, but I think I'm going to stick with white here. So great. I can also use a slider to adjust the text size, which is really nice. I'm going to leave it, I think, at about 45 or so. That's good. And now what I want to do is I want to add a black bar. I made a black bar in Photoshop just by making a rectangle. Doesn't matter how big you make it, but I just made a rectangle and filled it with black, and I saved it as a JPEG. And we're going to use the watermark tab up here, and we're going to click image type and click on the three dots here, and I'm going to find that black bar on my desktop and open that. You'll see it opens as a just a generic rectangle. I'm going to drag that the width of my movie and drag it down to the bottom where my captions are. And what you'll need to do is kind of scroll through your captions to find the tallest. Let's say it's two lines tall, and I'm going to drag this down to meet it. Just a nice comfortable area around it there. It's probably best to keep your captions to one or two lines, because if you go three, then, well, you'll see what happens here when I go from two to one. There's some extra space here, so you don't want a big extra space there. This is probably acceptable though. And now that I have that set, I can adjust the transparency. Let's say I want to go a little darker for a little more contrast. I'll set it to like something around 80%. So I can still see the movie through it, but I still have good contrast. And once that's set, you're all done. You can click done. And I'm going to make sure that MP4 is selected on the video tab here. And it's going to export it to my iSkySoft video converter in my movies folder. Now I'm just going to click convert. Now this is just a demo version of video converter. So it's going to ask you to buy, and what it will do, it's limited to 1/3 of your video on the demo, but we're going to use that just for this demonstration. So I click continue, and it's exporting my movie. This will create a new movie with my captions and the translucent background behind the captions. And once it's done, it's going to ask me if I want to open the folder. Okay, pretty quick. You can either buy it now or open the output folder. And it will take me right there. It's in my movies folder. And so I can double click that and open it. And I'm in QuickTime Pro already. You can see my captions are there. And if I scroll through it, you can see they're all there. And I'm going to go to the show movie properties. Remember how we had a video track and a text track and a soundtrack? Now we just have the soundtrack as stereo and the video track. The captions are now part of the video track. So if I were to upload this to YouTube, the captions would still be there. So that's why you want to think about using burned-in captions. This will also play in QuickTime 10, the default player that comes with your Mac.
Today I'm demonstrating.
And you can see my captions are there, but the QuickTime Text captions won't work in Windows Media Player. But if you save it this way as an MP4, Windows Media Player should be able to play it with the captions. So that's why you should think about burning your captions into the video layer of your movie, so it'll be more compatible with more different players and YouTube and some other services. Give iSkySoft Video Converter a little test drive for your own, and use MovieCaptioner to create the SRT file, and you'll be good to go. Thanks for watching.